Veteran journalist Virgil Santos joins us now for his assessment of the penultimate hearing on ABS-CBN's application for a new franchise, where lawmakers tackle the network's alleged bias reporting. Good afternoon, sir, and thanks so much for joining us.
Thanks for having me.
What's your assessment on the hearing of the alleged bias of ABS-CBN? Do you think that the network was able to effectively state its case enough to convince the majority of the lawmakers of its stand against bias?
I don't know about convincing them, but I find it very difficult to believe that some of our lawmakers have such impoverished understanding of a bedrock democratic principle like press freedom. They do not seem to understand that press freedom is something that lies beyond the power of state regulation, not Congress, not any other institution or agency can regulate press freedom, let alone ration it, such as what Congressman Defensor seems to me to have tried to do. Press freedom works itself out. It is the only force that can bring itself to bear on press freedom is the public itself, the market. If the market refuses to buy your newspaper, to read your newspaper, or listen to your radio station, or watch your television channel, you're finished. That's how press freedom works. But no government agency, not even Congress, can regulate press freedom. I can't quite understand this.
Right. One of the things that came up during the hearing was political bias. What about favoring certain candidates over others and airing political ads? Aren't there already safeguards against that and mechanisms to address it, such as and even penalties to impose against organizations found guilty of it?
I don't know about penalties. All I know is that nobody can tell a news organization what to do. Anyone can say what he or she likes about how a press or news organization conducts itself, but that's just about it. That is as much as they can do to make press organizations sit up probably and listen. But that's about it. These press organizations have editors who exercise the first level of control in their own news organization. But no outsider can do that. And I'm glad that press freedom has finally become a subject of discussion in this case, because press freedom, to me, is the only principle that applies in this case. Mm-hmm. All the other allegations, whether they've been proved or not, do not constitute any justification for denying ABS-CBN its franchise. Because if you deny ABS-CBN a renewal of its franchise, that constitutes a curtailment of the freedom that ABS-CBN has been exercising. They cannot do that.
Mm-hmm. Well, the media as the fourth estate was also discussed, and there have been allegations that it could have been more powerful than government so that it can be kingmaker and cannot be held liable for its freedom of speech and of the press. How would you see that kind of allegation?
They can allege all they like. But one thing is clear. What do the media have for power? Nothing but words. And this, if this is power, that also rests with everyone else, even Congress. Words, nothing but words. But look at the gross mismatch between the media and the government and other powers that be, that the media are supposed to watch. Look, we only have words. But look at what government has. They have Congress. This is a very good example of how this government can come together and bring whatever power it has to bear on the media. It has BIR, it has the security agencies, it has the National Telecommunications Commission. What do we have as news people? Nothing but words. And even these congressmen can have their own news organizations to enlist. And they've been doing that all along. And now they are saying that the media are so powerful. If, you know, the media, press freedom is enshrined in a special place in the Constitution because the framers themselves realized the lopsided, the mismatch between the media, the watchdog, and the powers that be. Mm-hmm. Look at what's happening. A very good illustration of this mismatch is what's happening in Congress now.
Right. Well, an organization which has an internal ethics manual, ombudsman, and externally, we also have other media organizations, the KBP, the MTRCB, and even the Omnibus Election Quotas Check and Balance, handling complaints against alleged bias, misreporting, sensationalism, factual inaccuracies, and others. Does the hearing seem to say that these safeguards and mechanism may not be enough? And if so, what more could be done?
Well, if you are lawmakers and considering their own interest, you will say that nothing is enough. Nothing is enough that will not give them the power to stop the media. The old adversarial relationship between the media and the government has been inspiring all these inanities. You know, all they want is to be able to control media. That's what they're trying to do now. But they cannot, because the Constitution will not allow them. I cannot imagine how what Congress is doing now to ABS-CBN will square with what the Constitution provides. I can't quite understand that. Mm-hmm. And it will only happen in a dictatorial. In a dictatorial situation.
Right. Well, there was an accusation about an imbalance in the reporting. Does journalism stop at getting all sides of the story? Do we angle the story so that we favor one side over another? Or is it, you know, the players in the story that tell us that?
No, journalists will just have to exert all effort to get at the truth. That's how it is. Basically, a story must have all critical sides to it. We always try to do that, because if we did not, we'll be in trouble with our public. We'll be in trouble with our market. Because we only rise and fall on our credibility. If we are seen by the public, by the market, as not credible, we will lose our business. That's why the check, the ultimate check on press and news organizations is the public. And Congress had better understand that early. Mm-hmm. Because if they are going to continue with this, they are shaming themselves. They're showing how impoverished their understanding of the of freedoms and rights and power in a democracy.
Mm-hmm. Well, how about guarding against spin doctors or taking press releases at face value? Plus, how much does context mean in making stories relevant and urgent? Does context affect our truth-telling and justice? These are some of the allegations that are put in Congress at the hearing yesterday. Do relevance and urgency mean sensationalism?
Everything has nuances. There is meaning, there is context, there is perspective. Of course, we try as best we can to put whatever we air or we print in context, in perspective. We try as best we can to provide our readers, our audiences, with all we can to make them understand what's happening around them better. We always try to do that. But of course, we are racing against a number of difficulties, like deadline and things like that. But all the same, whenever we can, and we should, we try to do the best we can. But whether we do our best or not, it is not for Congress to tell us that.
Mm-hmm. Well, of course, there are failures sometimes, there are mistakes, there are errors. And in the event that a media organization did make a mistake, does liability or redress end with issuing an errata or penalizing the guilty journalists involved in the wrong reporting, reaching out to the affected parties and tightening editorial protocols?
Oh, yes. Apologizing is always good, apologizing for one's mistake. In fact, I wish Congress would do that now and then. But, you see, it is not enough for certain people. And therefore, some people sue for libel. But, you see, it is again in the furtherance of press freedom that the universal trend today is to decriminalize libel. You know? Again, why? Because everybody understands, everybody who objectively looks at the situation sees, again, if I may labor it, again, that the relationship between press and government is so lopsided in favor of the government. That's why we are decriminalizing libel now.
And so on Thursday, of course, we're just going to be hearing the summation and interpolation, but what kind of vote are you expecting realistically? And what would be the best case scenario for you?
Theoretically, legally, morally, I would say ABS-CBN should have its franchise renewed. But if you're asking me what I expect realistically, I'm very afraid I'm not too sanguine.
On that note, veteran journalist Vergel Santos, thank you so much for always sharing your thoughts and insights with us today.
My pleasure and duty.